Code Composer Studio is an integrated development environment for Texas Instruments' embedded portfolio. When you run Code Composer Studio, it will prompt you to select a workspace. A workspace is a folder on your computer that is the default location for all of your projects and preferences. Code Composer Studio automatically configures itself to use a free license that supports working with XDS 100 and ICDI class debug probes, as well as development boards that have onboard debug capabilities, with the exception of MSP430 development boards. For MSP430 users, it supports working with any development board, but limits the code size to 16 kilobytes if you're using the optimized TI compiler. If you use GCC, which is available from the App Center, there is no code size limit. The window that you see now is the Getting Started view. It provides quick access to a number of common actions, such as creating a new project or browsing examples. You can also access the online support community, watch videos on the Code Composer Studio YouTube channel, visit the training site, or browse resources on the Code Composer Studio Developers Wiki. Another thing you can do from the Getting Started view is enable Simple Mode. Simple Mode strips down the user interface to just its basic functionality to make it easier to get started if you are more comfortable with a simplified environment. Let's create a new project. I click on the New Project button, and this launches the project wizard. First, I must specify the device I am creating the project for. As I type, the selections in the device box will be filtered, making it easier to find the one I am looking for. I can specify the type of debug probe that I am using. Next, I need to give the project a name. Here I can see where the project is going to be created. By default, this is within your workspace folder. But if you uncheck the box and specify a location, it will be created there instead. You can select the version of the TI or GCC compiler that you wish to use. And down at the bottom, there is a selection of basic templates that you can base your project on. For a greater selection of examples, you can use the Resource Explorer. I'm going to select the template to blink the LED. We can now click on Finish and create the project. On the left-hand side of the screen is the Project Explorer. This is your main window for managing projects. Note that in Code Composer Studio, projects are folder-based. If you copy a file into your project folder, it will automatically be considered part of the project. When you add source files to your project, you can choose to either add them to the project, in which case they will be copied into the project folder, or you can choose to link them to the project. When linking files, they are left in their original location, and the project will just have a reference to the file. Inside the project, you will see a number of files and folders that were added to the project by the project wizard. The Includes folder contains all of the compiler search paths for header files that have been specified in the project options. You can expand these and see all the files that are located in them. The Target Configs folder will be present if you specified a debug connection when generating your project. Inside that folder will be a CCXML file, which is the target configuration file. The target configuration file contains the information necessary to establish a connection to your target device, including the debug probe used and the device or board connected to it. The source files that are part of your project are shown, and you can see a CMD file. This is a linker command file. The linker command file specifies the device memory map for the linker, so the linker knows how to place your program code and data in memory. When you click on the Debug button, it will build the active project if it needs to be built, and then launch the debugger. Load the program and run to main. Note that the first time you build a project, it may take a bit of time. This will happen if the C runtime support library needs to be generated. When the debugger is launched, the way Code Composer Studio looks has changed. This is because it has switched from the edit perspective to the debug perspective. A perspective is an arrangement of menus, toolbar buttons, and windows. The edit perspective is tailored to writing code and building projects. The debug perspective is set up for debugging activities. By having specialized perspectives, you're able to have only those windows and views open that are applicable to what you are doing. On the toolbar, you can see which perspective you are in and can switch between perspectives simply by clicking on the one that you want. One of the most important windows in the debug perspective is the debug view. It shows you the active debug sessions, their state, and the call stack. The debug view controls the context of other views. Clicking on an item in the call stack, or in the case of a multi-core device, clicking on a core, will change the context of what is displayed in the other views to match what is selected in the debug view. On the main toolbar, you can see buttons for controlling the debug session. The Connect button will connect or disconnect the debugger from the device. You can specify a program to load. The Resume button runs the program. The Suspend button halts the program. The Terminate button will end the debug session and return to the edit perspective. There are buttons for stepping. You can reset the device. And the Restart button will return the program to its entry point. To keep things simple, by default, only a few windows are open. To access additional views, use the View menu. By selecting an item here, like the Breakpoints view, it will open it in the current perspective. When you are finished with the debug session, click on the Terminate button, and it will shut down the debugger and return to the edit perspective. Let's take a look at the App Center. The App Center is used to obtain additional software packages like Control Suite, MSP430ware, TivaWare, and TIRTOS. It also provides access to extra features that are not part of the standard CCS installation, like GUI Composer. You can even download and install various versions of the TI and GCC compilers. Once you have installed software packages via the App Center, you can then use the Resource Explorer to access the included examples. You can open the Resource Explorer from the Examples button on the Getting Started view, or by selecting Resource Explorer on the View menu. When you click on the Examples link, the Resource Explorer will show you all of the examples it has discovered on your computer. You can see here that it has found MSP430ware, TIRTOS, and TivaWare. The Resource Explorer also provides access to documentation and other resources for using the software packages. Let's select a project and start using it. I have a Tiva 129 connected launchpad on my PC. So let's expand TivaWare. I'm going to set up the interrupts example for that board. As you can see, there's a large selection of examples available. We can import the project into my workspace. You can see here that it is listed. I can then build the project. Notice how Code Composer Studio tells me when each step has been completed. I can specify the debug connection that will be used. The integrated ICDI debug interface has automatically been selected. And now I can proceed with debugging this project. As you can see, the Resource Explorer makes it easy to start working with examples. The executable generated by the project is now loaded on the device and ready to use. If you have questions on how to use Code Composer Studio, there are a number of resources available to you. The Code Composer Studio YouTube channel has a large number of quick tip and tutorial videos. The Code Composer Studio Development Wiki has a wide range of app notes and training material. The ETE support community is a great place for getting answers to questions. All of these resources are accessible from the Getting Started view, as well as the Help menu. Thank you for choosing TI Embedded Processors.